Hello guys and welcome, my name is Aaron Cooper. Welcome to a brand new video here today upon my channel guys. Today we're jumping into Tom Clancy's Ghost Recon Wildlands beta. And this is like my fifth video which I've done so far upon this little adventure throughout of this beta access. And hopefully you're all enjoying the previous videos which I've done so far on it. If, in case you've missed any of them, I'll leave them linked down below in the description so you can go ahead and check them out. And also there's a playlist upon my channel where you can check out all these great videos and much, much more. Anyways, we need something new that we can do. I'm trying to think. Should we go for a mission or something? Got rally point there. Let's go with this rebel op, which is like a side mission. We've got to start the radio. Okay. Right. Let's get my hands on a vehicle, and then we can make our way to our objective. Right, come on, team. Jump inside the Aaron Cooper mobile.
I'm cool. Let's move.
I'm one team member short. Ah, who's over there? Are you going to come get in the vehicle? I don't think this guy's listening to me. Why isn't he coming towards the vehicle? Why is he just standing there? This is weird, guys. I don't know if he's glitched or it's a bug or something, or if he's just not obeying orders. Right, we need to go investigate this. Right, excuse me, sir, you need to listen to me. I am your master. I am the man in charge. You need to come and get inside this vehicle. We need to go on a mission to go and start this radio, so you need to come with me. See, these other two team members are walking towards me as normal. That guy over there just not having none of it.
Buckle up, people.
This is just weird. Right, he needs to get inside this vehicle. I'm just going to leave the area without him. Right, you going to get inside the vehicle or not? Are you going to get inside this vehicle? Right, last chance now. Are you going to get inside this vehicle or am I just going to drive off without you? Screw it. You know what? Screw it. I'm not playing these little games. We need a four-man operation to go into this next mission. We need four people, but screw it. We'll just go with three. That guy can just stay there and do whatever he's doing. Right, let's go this way. According to my minimap, there's a helicopter down here. I'm not quite sure if it's the helicopter that I did end up smashing up. I'm not sure. Did I smash that helicopter up on my previous video? I think I did. Oh dear. Is it still operational? Can I still fly this thing? No, I can't. It's completely bust. That is bust, guys. Seeing it, there's no chance of that getting up in the air. Right, we need a vehicle. Because I ain't walking to my next objective. Screw that. It'll just take us forever. Right, get out of the vehicle and nothing will happen to you. Alright, come on.
I'll catch up with you.
Okay, is this guy gonna jump on the back?
Listen up for a special message from El Sueño.
Right, screw it. Do you know what? There's a vehicle at the far end of the road over there. I'm just gonna go over to that vehicle and hope that it's like a four-seater car because I see it as... I've got no time to be waiting for my team members to decide on whether or not they're gonna jump inside this vehicle with me. I'm too tired for that today, guys. I'm too tired for it. Alright, let's tag and bag these supplies. There we go. We tagged the gasoline there.
My beautiful gasoline.
Right. Oh, I've got a three-man team. Look at this. All three of my team members are coming to me. We're now a four-man operation. Right. After all that hard effort of making that guy come with us, I see it as he must have realised he was going to be there on his own all day, probably going to end up getting bored. So he's thinking, do you know what, I'm going to join the team, and we're going to go on a mission. Gotta love this cheesy music as well on the radio. Kind of reminds me of something that you listen to in Super Mario. Dude. Right, I just realised I have to get myself out of the zone there, guys. Literally, I was just like focused more on the music. I wasn't really paying attention to where I was going. So it's a good job I did notice that I was going the wrong way. Get a little bit too carried away here. Right. If my eyes aren't deceiving me, I see my beautiful flying contraption right there. And it's a beautiful helicopter there. It needs a pilot like me to operate and fly into the sky. And even though I'm a terrible pilot at this game, I mean, I can fly this thing, but I'm not very good at landing it. I see it as, I'm going to give this bad boy a go, because the factors I've noticed with this game, in particular, I see it as, if you want to get around the map a lot more quicker to get to an objective quicker, it's easier to do it inside a helicopter. Because you can get there so easily than you can when it comes to using a vehicle. Because when you're using a car or something, or a motorbike on this, I see it as, I feel like it takes forever to get around the map, but helicopter, you can just fly over all the roads, over the mountains, and just go to your objective. It's just so much easier. Take this for example. Look at this, right? I've flown over loads of roads already, and I'm almost there. But at the same time, I just don't want to end up crashing, so I need to be careful. Ooh. Focus on flying this properly, but there we go. Almost there now. I've got to go and start that radio. Wherever that radio is, but what I'm going to do, I'm going to try and land this in a good little area near to my objective. Try not to smash this up. Easy now. Want to be able to fly out of here afterwards. I don't want to like have a smashed up helicopter in the middle of like a random area. Careful. Careful. That'll do. That's just nice. Right there. That's just nicely. Very nicely indeed. Right. Start this radio. Right, we've got the defender radio, because I'm guessing we're going to have some enemies coming in onto my position, so we need to prepare for this, guys.
Have a single source, the Santa Blanca cartel. They infect our children with evil. They steal our land. They enslave us. They make our families disappear, and no one does anything. El Falso Santo has sold their fear across our great country. But we know it is lies, and we are not afraid. Join us, hermanos, and we will solve these problems one bullet at a time.
Right, I've just realized something as well, guys. Is that we're meant to be defending this radio, but there's no enemies in this area. It's like no one's coming towards me to try and stop me. So where am I meant to be defending it from? Civilians? Houses? My helicopter? I don't know.
Good people.
There's some enemies down the road, but they aren't even my fuss that I'm in this area here.
You got a tango with multiple
so you can become slaves to the cartel. I say no. We are born free, and we
should
cannot
shoot them?
Live in chains.
Not yet. Are they going to leave them for five? Let's get this radio out of the way before I focus on killing them, guys.
Bolivianos.
I'm not going to shoot you, I mean you no harm. I'm here to defend a radio. Just go and do what you're doing. And just stay out of my line of sight.
Must we lie awake as well? Wondering if a straight bullet might come through their bedroom walls and take them from us? If we do not take our country back, those bullets will find us, one way or another.
Four, three,
if we are to die,
two.
Let it be on our
there we go, guys. Completed that side mission there. That was kind of easy. I didn't even have to defend it from anyone. Like, I think originally there was meant to be some enemies here, I'm guessing, but for some reason there just wasn't. But obviously, in case you guys weren't aware of this rebel support, basically what you can do with this, you can summon in rebels to help you. To, like, say if there's, say you've got loads of the Unidad army chasing you, like the Unidad patrols trying to kill you. Some of these rebels, you can summon them in, and they'll give you a hand in taking them down. Let's get rid of these guys right here, because they've got civilians in front of them. And I don't want them causing any more of a nuisance.
More cartel handiwork. Fucking animals.
Ooh. Right, let's go over here. I spy with my little eye something beginning with D. And I'm not talking about Doritos. I'm literally talking about this document. And I'm taking it.
Camaradas, hermanos, fellow cocaleros. Camaradas, hermanos, fellow cocaleros.
Right. What I need to do now, I need to make my way back to my helicopter. And get this bad boy back up into the sky, because I want to find some more missions or something I can do. I need to keep myself busy when I'm playing this beta. There's a lot more stuff we can do, and I can imagine that when the full game comes out on the 7th of March, I can imagine there's going to be a ridiculous amount of cool stuff you can do in this. So it's going to be insane. Alright, we've got a skill point over here which you can focus on getting to. Wait for my team now.
We are tired.
Come on, team.
We are desperate.
Let's take to the sky and do what we need to do.
We are Bolivians.
So yeah, I hope you all enjoyed the video so far, guys. If you are, then give this video a thumbs up and subscribe. We really, really would appreciate it. If you are new to the channel, make sure you hit the subscribe button. And also, there's like a notification bell right next to it. If you click that, you'll be notified as soon as I upload any new content upon my channel, so you can never miss out on any of my videos. And also, like I mentioned at the start of the video, if you're enjoying these Wildland videos that I've been doing on the beta access, then the rest of them will be linked down below in the description to all of my previous videos which I've done on it so far. In case you missed any of them, they will be linked down below. But we've come into enemy territory right here now, so we need to be extra careful. They know I'm here. Right, we need to wipe these out. I need to do it quietly. Let's be careful. Nicely done there. That makes two. That's three. Come on. Ooh, no. Careful. Oh, no. Move. There we go. We just nearly just been blown up there, so we need to be extra careful now. I don't want to die. Not today, Charlie. I don't want to die. It's all right. I've got two enemies right in front of me. So I've got plenty of bullets to go around, so it's going to be all right. Checking if any more enemies are here. Taking down like a boss. Just checking behind me just in case any more enemies are coming. Because you have to make sure on these things. Because you don't want to be locking down one positioning and then not covering your six, which is basically covering your behind, in case you didn't know my technical words there. Sitters, we need to make sure that no one's going to like flank me and take me down. But to be honest, if anyone's going to get shot at the moment, it's going to be my team member if he's not careful. He's just running straight into open areas. Look at this, guys. He's already been shot at. No. Careful. I'm being shot at. And obviously now, in case you guys can't see, because obviously my face cam will be in the way, is that I've summoned, like, there's like a wanted level within the Ghost Recon Wildlands beta. It's kind of similar to the GTA wanted level that you see in Grand Theft Auto games. And I see there's normally in Grand Theft Auto, you've got the stars. And, like, they get difficult. Like, you get loads of enemies coming after you. Like, you know, helicopters and stuff coming after you. Like, depending on what your star level is. But with this, you've got the Unidad patrols. And at the moment, I've got one out of four. So I'm going to get some people in cars coming after me. And if that keeps increasing, I'm going to have people in helicopters. And it just gets more and more and more insane every single time that level goes up. So, I see it is. We're going to have a little bit of fun. Going to get this level up a little bit more, I think. We're going to have a little bit of fun with these guys. And if things get a little bit too hectic with helicopters and stuff, if any more do come after that point, then I'm going to have to flee the area and get out of here as soon as possible. Because I don't want to have too much fun with them, because the thing is, they'll keep summoning them, and I'll have loads of them coming after me, and they'll probably end up like messing me up. We'll wait for these guys to leave the vehicle. Come on, get out of the vehicle. Got three enemies right in front of me. Alright, it's time to put them down. Ooh, got the second marker now. 2 out of 4 on my Unity Patrols marker. I'm just going to call it like the wanted level. It'll be easier. It's easier to for you guys to understand. Right, we need to quickly get inside our helicopter if it isn't too wrecked. It does look like it's been taking quite a beating though. Please let me inside the helicopter. Please? No, that's definitely been smashed open there, guys. Look at that. It looks wrecked. Right, so we need a vehicle. We need to flee this area before things get a little bit too more hectic. But we've got some enemies up ahead, so we might as well take these guys out before we adventure into another area.
This is history.
Ooh, one more.
Stay still, sir. I need to put some bullets in you.
There we go. Taken down. We've got more cars on the way, so we need to get our vehicle and get out of here as soon as possible, literally. Right, let's go for this one. I think me and my team would like this car.
I'll drive.
Right, come on, team. Hurry up and get inside of the vehicle so we can get out of this area before more patrol cars end up turning up. Right, go. I'm going to have to go this way. I don't feel like I can land it on the road properly. No! The car's flipped over. Right, get out of the car. Right, we need a new vehicle. Get out of the vehicle. Right, screw it. We've got another vehicle right here. Get out of the vehicle right now.
I'm taking your vehicle for a spin.
Right, come on, team. I need you to get inside this vehicle. Team? Team, get inside the vehicle. Oh no, they got themselves into a lot of bother here. This is what happens when you don't supervise your team properly. They're just going to get themselves locked into the middle of a war zone. Oh, I've got some rebels that are coming in to join me.
How you doing, brothers?
There you go, rebels are attacking the Unidad. Right, so these coming in just to give me a little hand, which I really do appreciate it. Gives me enough time for me and my team to escape this area and get out of here. Let the rebels deal with them. Or if my team don't hurry up and get inside this car, I'm just going to end up getting peppered by these guys. Alright, come on. Try running over there, that was an epic fail. We're just going to do some dangerous off-road driving now and just hope and pray that we don't smash the car up too much. Go, 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 go. Let's keep going, keep going, keep going. We do need a better vehicle, to be honest. Find someone with a vehicle. Right, this person. Right. Excuse me, sir, I mean you no harm. Please step out of the vehicle, or I'll be forced to take action. Get out of the vehicle. Move. Right, there we go. Right, come on, team. Right, let's go. We've got 3 more missions we can do. We've got 6 more Kingslayer files to find. One more weapon case, one more accessory case, and we've still got skill points and a bonus medal to find, so we've still got quite a bit to do yet. They're wrecking my vehicle already. Right. According to my mini-map, there's a Unidad patrol car right up ahead, and it's parked behind a rock. But why is it there? I'm thinking we should go investigate. Okay. I'm sorry, boys. I didn't mean to disturb your romantic evening of you boys just chilling inside a car behind a rock in the middle of a highway doing absolutely nothing. So, Cetus, I think I deserved that. I think I disturbed their romantic evening. I ain't getting my words out today.
Hostile down.
Right. Take that car for a spin.
Good to go.
I didn't even see any of my team members getting inside this car. Right, screw it. Do you know what? I'm just going to run them over. There we go. Come on, my friend. No. Well, I think my team member's going to kill him anyway. Let's keep pushing up. We've been playing for quite a little while now, guys. We've been playing for about 21 minutes already. Time flies. We need to just flee this area at the moment, though, because we've got a lot of enemies behind us. But at this present moment in time, with my team members popping the reds out of the car windows and everything, it does feel like I'm playing a little bit of GTA, if you know what I'm saying. It's just one of those sort of things. Keep going. Right. Let's head up here. Ooh, Aaron Cooper can't drive to save his life, literally. What the hell? Guys, I think I'm stuck. I can't move. Literally, I'm stuck in this little spot between a car wheel and the side of a car and a rock. I can't move. Is there like a way of pushing this car or something? I'm kind of stuck. I might need to end up fast traveling or something to get myself out of this area because I literally can't move from that spot. I'm stuck. Need a fast travel location. Where's the nearest fast travel location? Well, let's keep trying just for a sec. And if I can get out of it, then it's alright. But if I can't, then I'm going to have to fast travel.
They're looking for you. Watch yourself.
Well, if they're looking for me, I can't really do nothing about it because I can't even leave the spot. Right. Let's just fast travel. It'd be so much easier if we just fast travel. Right, here we go. This is just mad, this game is. I absolutely love it, though. It's awesome. You can have a lot of fun with this game. I see, I have this sort of, like, vibe I get for this game. A similar sort of vibe I get when I play The Division. A lot of people have, like, mixed opinions on The Division. I think The Division is a great game. It does, like, offer a lot of, like, great gameplay experiences. But also, I can see some of the negative points that a lot of people do make about the game. And a lot of people have, like, a mixed judgment of this. Particularly like beta so far, because obviously the full game isn't even out yet, but with Wildlands, I don't know, I find that it's got more of this freedom to it, like you've got a lot more that you can do with this game. But I'm hoping when the full game's out, there's going to be a lot of cool stuff that they're going to be added into it. I know they're going to be doing something like PvPs or something like that, but it's just one of them things. It's like, I'm just hoping that there's going to be a lot to offer in the full development of this game. So then it can keep you busy for a very long time. Alright, come on. You need to get inside the helicopter.
I'm in. Let's go.
You're not in the helicopter. Come on. Stop faffing around now. Come get inside the helicopter. Come on. There we go. He's finally got inside the helicopter. Well, it took him like 5 million years. It's all right. Detected a little bit of sarcasm there. It's all right. Right, so shall we go to this particular location? And screwdriving there. We're going to fly there. Look at all these roads I do not have to drive up. I can just fly all the way past them. As high as a kite. And be able to get there no problemo. According to my minimap as well, there's also a helicopter in this area as well. So if things do go down, like if there's a lot of action that does go down in this area, then I have got a helicopter, so it should be okay. Careful. Right, I need to get myself into cover because, according to my minimap, there's a lot of enemies in this area. That's one. Right, we're rattling people's cages here, so we need to be extra careful. Right, careful. Taking down another one there. We need to bag and tank these supplies. We have got a helicopter up here as well in case I need it. No, get into cover. Right, we need to find a sniper. Found him. Right, there we go. We're going to try to pop him off from this range. Nice and easy. Taken down like a boss, just the way I like to do it. Literally, you give that guy no chill there. We took him out from quite a distance away. Using an AR, you know what I mean? My beautiful assault rifle. Right, got quite a few enemies down here as well, so what I might do is chuck a couple of grenades in. Let them introduce themselves. Boom. Right, my wanted level from the Unidad patrols has gone up to 2 out of 4 so far. So things could end up getting messy at this rate. So I need to be really, really careful. So a nice little look around as well. Because always, the one thing I would recommend when you play this game, pretty much with most games in general actually, is that be aware of your surroundings so that you know where there's good cover points, you know where you can flee to if in case things get out of control, and be aware of the vehicles around you as well, because the fact is, if you've got the vehicles near you, you know you've got yourself something that can help you get away if things do get a little bit too hectic. So in my case, with this particular area I'm in, I've got a helicopter. And also I've got my helicopter if it isn't too battered. But let's go with no pain. Nicely done. There we go. Beautiful. Got the diversion grenade. It's alright. Right, I've been spotted. It's alright though, guys. It's alright. Got the rebels as well. The rebels are coming in to help me out here. Take down the Unidad. Let's give him a grenade or two. Tango down. Right, is this guy going to pop his head around that corner so I can shoot him? No, let's go around here instead. And, nice. Got more of them now. Let's give him a grenade. Nice. Now we've got up to the 3 out of 4 for the Unidad patrols. Things are about to get a little bit more hectic now.
Fucking hell.
Right, go. I've even got the Unidad patrols got helicopters out as well. No! We got helicopters. I need my helicopter. Please, be a working tack. No, it's damaged. It's damaged. Right, I'm going to get a little bit screwed now. I need to get to that helicopter up here as quickly as possible, and we need to get out of this area before I get turned into mincemeat. Right, come on team, quick. Just hurry up and get to this helicopter because they can easily get me because I'm in this stale position, literally. I'm staying still. I need to hurry my team up. Team! I'm being shot at. Hurry up. Come on! Get to the chopper as soon as possible, okay? Right, go. I need to move as soon as possible. My helicopter's taking quite a beating at the moment. We need to proper try and shake off these helicopters that are behind me and try and lose their line of sight. Alright, let's keep going. Come on. We can do it. There we go. We've lost the Unidad Patrol's line of sight, so we should be okay for now. I'm just going to keep going in this direction for now. I'm going to try and see if we can do like some wacky stunts inside this helicopter, but no, my luck, I probably can't pull them off. I'll try not smash this thing up. I can't promise anything, but I'll try.
Meow. Meow.
Gavel. I can do it. No! I can't do it. I smashed that helicopter up into pieces. I told you I'm a bad pilot, guys. It's a good job this is a computer game and not real life, because I ain't paying for that. I just ain't paying for the cost of the damage for that thing. What I am going to do, though, is I'm going to steal another helicopter. And I want to go to somewhere else. Where shall we go to? Hunt the rebel agents. Okay, let's try this one out. So Menendez's farm at the moment. And I'm only here because he's got a helicopter. And I want this helicopter. Right, jump beside the helicopter team. Come on. We ain't got all day. In fact, you know what? There's something here that I need. So you guys wait there. I'm just going to pop inside this barn area. I believe there's a document. I'm taking it. Right, now we can get back into the helicopter. Right, come on team, hurry up. Here we go.
I believe I can fly.
Nah, I'm not technically flying. I'm flying in a helicopter. I'm not flying. This air transport is flying. I just couldn't get my words out there. Well, technically I am flying. If you have to think about it, I am technically flying. I'm operating it. Right, let's keep pushing up a little bit. Want to make sure I land this near to the objective so I can get out of line of sight straight afterwards. I don't want to be too close, but I don't want to be too far away at the same time, if you know what I'm saying. So, if we land right about here, should be okay. Right. Got quite a lot of enemy activity up ahead, so we need to be extra careful now. Right. That's one. That's two. He's on alert. That's three. Need any more? I can hear enemies, but I just can't see them. Knock, knock. Anyone home? Hey, buddy. How you doing? Nicely done that. We even broke his window in the process. Alright, is there anything that's worth any value that's here that I can take? At the moment I can't see anything that's of value. I can even hide in the trunk. That is just awesome. I bet you, when it comes to the full game, there's going to be a mission or something where you got to hide in the trunks of cars or something. That would be awesome if there is.
We'll let the rebels know where to find these supplies. They can pay us back later.
Right. What shall we do next? After we pit our skills. Got battery, got night vision. Got the battery. Nicely done. Got the battery, got the night vision. Wonder what we're gonna be using them for. It's pretty obvious. Where shall we go to next? I'm thinking. Steal the plane. Looking promising. Let's go steal a plane. Right, I need a car or a helicopter. I need my helicopter. Where did I park it? I think I parked it somewhere down here. But there's cars around here as well. Helicopter. My beautiful friend, Heli. Right, we can do this. And it doesn't look too battered. Just looks a little bit dead. Right. Come on, team. We've got another helicopter slash plane to steal. Why not? Let's keep going. There's one thing that you can really appreciate as well, guys. When you are in these helicopters or in a plane or something on this game, you can appreciate the nice, beautiful view that you can see and how good this world looks. Like, this game's world looks amazing. Looks like something you see inside a Far Cry game. Let's keep going. Almost there now. Is it a bird? Is it a plane? No, it's Aaron Cooper going insane.
Going insane in the membrane.
Right. Let's land this bad boy. Just gotta be extra careful now. Alright, I'm gonna plan this smartly.
Drone is airborne.
Right, I've gotta pick out my targets using my drone. Four of them so far, five. Is anyone else? There's gotta be more than five. Clearly there's gotta be more. No, I generally think there's only five. Oh, is there any more? I've got five. I can't see any more. Right. Let's pop them off one by one. If I play it smart, I can kill them all. One.
We're cool, we're cool.
Two.
Looks like they're feeling froggy.
Three.
Oh shit, we've been
four.
Spotted.
Five. Has anyone come steal this plane? Anyone dare to come steal this plane off me? Ain't gonna happen. Right. Let's pick up my beautiful skill point. This is mine.
This with my Class A uniform.
I don't really call it a Class A uniform. I'd call it more of a casual uniform, if I'm honest. Right.
Let's go.
Right, can I recoup a fly this plane without smashing it up then? Let's find out. We've got to take the plane to the rebel held airport.
No problemo.
Let's do this. Whoa.
Meow.
I'm an awesome pilot. Nah, I'm not an awesome pilot. I think I do alright. Just put a bit more practice, I think I'll be doing a lot more better. It just seems a lot more easier to fly this than it does to other games. Like, I could probably fly a million planes on this game than be able to fly at least like 5 planes in a Battlefield game, because I cannot fly helicopters or planes in that game to save my life. But that's obviously because I don't have much practice when it comes to vehicles. When it comes to Battlefield games, because I prefer to be on the ground shooting. But, I don't know. It's just one of them things. Hold L2 and I can brake and land. No problemo. Can I recuper land it? He's landed it. I've landed it. The plane is still intact. It's still in one piece. We did it.
Good work. The rebels will be damn glad to get their hands on this cargo. Let's head out. We'll tell them where to find the plane later.
So here we go, guys. What I'm going to do now, I'm going to bring this video to an end. If you did enjoy the video, then make sure you give it a thumbs up and subscribe. I really would appreciate it. This was like the 5th video now upon the Ghost Recon Wildlands beta access. I'll leave a link down below in the description to all of my previous videos which I've done on this so far. Look out for even more videos on the Wildlands beta leading up to all the way to its launch date, which is out on the 7th of March, I believe. And I'll see you all again next time upon another brand new video. Until then, take care and hope you all have a marvelous day.